be the man to be replaced. Glenn Hoddle. Kenny Sanson. Waddle wide to the left. Four England players in the middle. One of the problems sometimes when Waddle comes on the left, he restricts the movement forward of Kenny Sanson, who, when he makes his forward runs, always tends to make them wide, unlike one or two players we've seen in this tournament who come down the middle, the Brazilian Branco being a prime example. Fenwick. And Maradona being left forward, it's got to go back to Peter Shilton. Whistles from the crowd, but it was the only ball on for Fenwick. Stevens. Lineker starts to come short, then goes. This is Hodge, as the sweeper comfortably across. Barnes still waiting. And with a little over a quarter of an hour left, there would seem to be no point in delay. And there is not going to be further delay. Off comes Trevor Stevens, and on into the World Cup for the first time comes Watford's John Barnes. He's gone to the left, Waddle has gone to the right, and England are playing two in midfield, Hodge and Hoddle. Sanson, Butcher, Valdano, Batista, Brown, and anyway we'll do clearance, but so was Fenwick. If we don't get hold of the ball, we can do nothing with it. Free kick has been given. Minutes remaining. Argentina 2, England 0. They've only once previously beaten us, and that was in June 1964 in the Brazilian Jubilee tournament in Rio. And they won by the only goal. And Argentina are bringing off Buruchaga. And another new man gets into the World Cup because he's going to be replaced by Marcelo Fabiani. No, he's going to be replaced by Marcelo Tapia. And having suggested two surnames, let's get the right Christian name. On the field is number 20, Carlos Tapia, and he played once before. Beardsley, free kick against his marker, Cuchufo. Tapia's previous appearance was in the opening game against South Korea when he came on as a substitute. Waddle to take, Barnes starts to make a run, so does Hodge, they all go back. Waddle is the nearest, there's an awful lot of movement from England players. Fenwick at the back, Hodge even further back. And Butcher's header straight into the hands of Pumpido. All sorts of movements then from the England players. Fenwick, Hodge, Butcher, but straight to the advanced goalkeeper. England ball. Butcher. Four up for England. Sanson in possession. Valdano sitting it out. The referee, unimpressed, tells him to get up. Waddle, forward of the ball. And the free kick has been given for the challenge on Kenny Sanson. And Maradona delaying things by getting involved. As with his team, there are certainly two sides of his character. Enrique got away with throwing the ball away. there's quite a delay before this free kick is taken. Hoddle will take it. Butcher, Stevens, Waddle and Lineker to come from the near side as we look. And the Argentines move up en masse. And the England players are all caught offside. From where is the inspiration to come?
Not an easy position to be in against such a determined Argentine side. I don't know what Bobby Robson will be thinking at this moment, just praying for help from somewhere. The pity is, of course, that his team has not really played in this game as they have done in others. It is true the opposition are that much more difficult, but on the other hand, just to throw the ball away, as has happened so often when not under pressure, has not been typical of their last two games, and it's put them really in the trouble that they're in.
I think it is also true to say that observers of world football would have suggested at the start of this tournament that for England to reach the quarterfinals was achievement for the team that came here. Hodge tried to get forward under that from Beards' little flick. The free kick has been given. A little over 10 minutes left. Butcher is forward, just out of picture as we look. And he's the widest player from the view of the kicker. Hodge, Waddle, Fenwick, Butcher, Lineker. Fenwick is the first to go. Kemp's Brown, the back man. Hoddle and Barnes together. And Barnes just runs over it. And Hoddle doesn't find him. Oh dear.
I suppose that's the reason that players don't often show imagination from free kicks, because when they don't work, they get the derision of the crowd. It was an attempt, at least, to be positive and slip somebody through the block.
Here's Fenwick. Stevens. Fenwick is still forward. This is John Barnes. Away by Ruggeri. Only to Kenny Sansom. To Hodge. Appeals for offside. He wasn't. This is John Barnes. That's nicely done. That's a good cross. They're queuing up. Lineker! 9 minutes left. And English hopes are rekindled. And John Barnes, who has had to stay for so long as a spectator, did what we know he can do. Got to the byline. A lovely cross. And Lineker gets goal number 6 in this competition. But more importantly than that statistic, he gives England a chance of saving the day. There were players queuing then for that cross. So beautifully played it was. Here's Maradona with his spin turn. Back from Tapia and back again. Sanson's challenge. Tapia off the post. The gods were on our side there, all right. Great spin turn by Maradona, and John Barnes was back in defence to bring it out again. And on the other flank, here is Chris Waddle. If it is to be the end, it's going to be a stirring finish from England. Flag is up for offside. And that goal for Gary Lineker means that he has now scored more goals in World Cup football than any other Englishman. Before this match, he stood level on 5 with Jeff Hurst. Hurst's goals coming in 2 competitions. Now he's past that, as well as having reached the position of being England's top scorer in 1 tournament.
And 1 more from inside the 6-yard box.
But if you produce a cross like that, Jimmy, you want somebody to put it in the net. Valdano and Sansom.